हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, और टुडेज टॉपिक इज काउंटिंग. सो लेट्स लर्न द कंसेप्ट ऑफ काउंटिंग. डू यू नो व्हाट डज द टर्म काउंट मीन्स? इन मैथ काउंट कैन बी डिफाइंड एज इट इज द एक्ट ऑफ डिटरमाइनिंग द क्वांटिटी और द टोटल नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन अ गिवन सेट और in a group. Okay, to count means to say numbers in order. Now let's take one example. If there are numbers from 1 to 10, how do you count? You count starting from 1. Yes, so let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This process is called as counting. There are two methods of counting. First is counting forward and backward, and the second is counting in groups. So let's see one by one. Now, forward counting. Forward counting is counting by adding one more every time. And what does the backward counting mean? Backward counting is counting in reverse order. Okay, we previously counted numbers from 1 to 10 in forward direction. That means that's forward counting. Now let's see counting in backward sequence. Okay, like backward counting. So let's start. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This process is called as backward counting. Do you understand? Now let's study it by taking one simple example. We have some balls. Okay, we will arrange in single row. Okay, what we have to do? First we have to count that balls in forward direction, and then we have to count it in backward direction. Okay, let's start. First we have to do forward counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now backward counting. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes, this is the first method of counting, and it represents the very basic method of counting. Do you understand? Okay, so let's start the second method of counting, that is counting in groups. Let's learn the concept of counting in groups by taking one example. Here are some balls. There are two balls on the upper side and three balls in the lower side. Now, you have to count upper balls, then the lower balls. Okay? So let's start. 1, 2. So write down 2 beside that. Yes. Now the lower row. 1, 2, 3. Then write down 3. Now what you have to do? You have to add these two numbers. 2 + 3 equal to, yes, 5. That means there are 5 balls in this set. That means this process is counting in groups. It will be very easy than our first method. Do you understand? That's very good. Now what you have to do? Try counting the objects in your surrounding. Like how many balls you have? Do you have 3 balls? How many pencils you have? 2 pencils? How many crayon colors you have? 12 colors? Yes. In this way, you have to count different objects in your surrounding area. Okay? That's all for today. See you soon.